Namaste children, welcome to today's mathematics class. In the previous class we have solved brain teasers, second main, third main and fourth main. Today we are going to solve from fifth main. So fifth main heading is given, evaluate the following by using a suitable identity. So make sure that suitable identity. So the first question is 399 whole square. Here it's a 3-digit number, 399, which is nearer to 400, right? So for 400, some number should be subtracted to come into 399. What is that number? 1. Yes. So 399 can be written as 400 minus 1 whole square. Can you suggest me which identity can be used here? Yes, a minus b whole square. So a minus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab. By comparing, the a value is 400 and the b value is not minus 1 children, only 1, because we have like signs here. Clear? Then substitute these values of a and b in the identity, we'll get 400 minus 1 whole square equal to 400 square plus 1 square minus 2 into 400 into 1. Then 4 square is nothing but 16. Double zeros means 4 zeros you'll get here. Plus 1 minus 4 twos are 800. Now simplify this. So with these two we'll get 1, 5, 9, 8, 0, 0. Sorry, not 8, it is 2, because 10 minus 8 is 2. Okay, plus 1. Then the final answer is 159201. That is 159201. Now we'll move to second question. The second question given is 62 whole square. 62 can be written as 60 plus 2 whole square. Right? Because 62. It's not 65 and above, it is 65 and below. So we'll go for previous. Then it can be used which identity? A plus b whole square. Then it a square plus 2ab plus b square. Then comparing, the a value is 60 and the b value is 2. Substitute in the identity, 60 plus 2 whole square equal to 60 square plus 2 into 60 into 2 plus 2 square. Then 6 square is nothing but 36. Single zero, double time you will get, because of square, plus 6 twos are 12, 12 twos are 24. So 240 plus 4. Add up, then you will get 4. Then here 4, 6 plus 2, 8. Then 3, you will get 3844. So we'll move to the third question, children. Children, this means all questions are very important. So 103 into 97. 103 into 97. This question is very important, children. So 103 into 97. Please don't multiply. You are not a second standard or third standard child. You are 8th standard. Now you need to use the identity and solve this. So 103, it's a 3-digit number. So nearest to 103 is 100. So 100 plus 3, 97. 2-digit number, though it is more than 95. So we need to go for next number, that is 100. 100 minus 3 is equal to 97, right? Yes, suggest me the identity which can be used. These two are same, these two are same with opposite sign. That's nothing but a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. Compare, the value of a is 100 and the value of b is 3. Then substitute in the identity, 100 plus 3 into 100 minus 3 is equal to a square. A square, then a value is 100 square minus b value is 3, it's a square. Then 100 square is not 1000, it is a 10,000. Minus 3 square is 9. Then 10,000 minus 9 is 9,991. Hope it is clear for your children. Now we'll move to fourth question. So fourth question is 10.1 whole square. 10.1 means 10 plus 0.1 is nothing but 10.1. Then which identity? A plus B whole square identity. A square plus B square plus 2AB, or you can write it as A square plus 2AB plus B square. Okay. A value is 10, B value is 0.1. Then substitute in the identity, 10 plus 0.1 whole square equal to 10 square plus 0.1 whole square plus 2 into 10 into 0.1. Just for change, I have taken 2AB at the last. Okay. Then 10 square is nothing but 100 plus 1 square is nothing but 1. Since after decimal point you have one digit, but since it is a square, you should have two digits, so it can be written as 0.01. Plus 2 tens are 20, 21s are 20, but after point you have one number, so from right side one digit. Then 100 plus 2 is 102 plus 0.01. Then the final answer is 102.01. Okay. Now we'll move to the fifth question. The fifth question is 85 square minus 75 square. This is very clear for you. It's A square minus B square. We know that A square minus B square is nothing but A plus B into A minus B. Don't go for taking the square of this number, square of this number. I can subtract it. Okay, it's waste of time, children. A value is 85. B value is 75. Then you'll get 85 whole square minus 75 whole square equal to A value is 85 plus B value is 75 into 85 minus 75. Then 85 plus 75, 5 plus 5 is 10, 8 2 is 16. So 160 you'll get into 85 minus 75 is 10. Then 16 ones are 16, double 0. So 1600. I'll go with the sixth question now. Yes, sixth question. 291 into 309. Since it is a 3-digit number, round off to next 3-digit number is 300. So for 300, what I need to subtract to get 291? Yes, 9 I have to subtract, right? Then 309. 3-digit, nearest 3-digit for 309 is 300 plus 9. So is it nothing but A minus B into A plus B? Yes. It's nothing but A square minus B square. Now compare. A value is 300 and the B value is 9. Then it becomes 300 minus 9 into 300 plus 9 is equal to 300 square minus 9 square. 300 square, 3 square is 9, 2 zeros, double it, so 4 zeros. Then it becomes 90,000 minus 81, because 9 square is 81. Then subtraction, 10 minus 1 is 9, then you will get 9, 9 minus 8 is 1, next 9, 9, 8, that is 89,919. Hope this is clear for your children. 89,919. So this is how the fifth main is solved. Now we'll move to the sixth main, children. Okay. So heading of sixth main, evaluate for x if 36x equal to 78 square minus 42 square. So we need to solve for x. So can any identity can be used in the RHS side? Yes, A square minus B square. So we know that A square minus B square is nothing but A plus B into A minus B. So the value of A is 78 and the value of B is 42. Clear? So 36x equal to A square minus B square means A plus B. A plus B. A value is 78 plus B value is 42 into A minus B. That is 78 minus 42. Then 36x equal to 8, 9, 10. Then 7, 11, 12. 120 into then 8 minus 2 is 6, then 7 minus 4 is 3, 36. Don't multiply and waste your time, children. Now see the relation between 36 and x. It is under multiplication. Multiplication changes to division. Then 120 into 36 divided by 36. 36, 36 get cancels. Then the value of x is 120. Is it not the simple? And this main is very important for the examination point of view, children. They'll ask for 3 marks or else for 4 marks. Now let me go for second one. In the same main, second question. So that is 6.2x equal to 8.1 into 8.1 minus 1.9 into 1.9. What is the difference between first question and second question, children? Nothing. Here he gave himself already, they are in square. But whereas here he didn't give, it is repeated. We know that a number repeated by itself is nothing but a square of a number, right? Which we learned in first chapter. Then 6.2x equal to 8.1 square minus 1.9 square. Is it nothing but a square minus b square? We know that a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. Compulsory, you should write the identity which you are using, children. A value is 8.1 and the b value is 1.9. Clear? Then 6.2x equal to 8.1 plus 1.9 because of a plus b. Now for a minus b, 8.1 minus 1.9. Then 6.2x equal to, add up these two, 9 plus 1 is 10, then 8, 9, 10, then 10.0. 10.0 is nothing but 10 only, okay? Then 8.1 minus 1.9, we'll get 11. 11 minus 9 is 2 point, this is of 7, 7 minus 1 is 6, then 6.2. Again check the relation with coefficient and the x, multiplication changes to division. 10.0 is nothing but 10 only, then 6.2 divided by 6.2 because this multiplication changes to division. This is same, then x equal to 10. Hope this is easy for you now, children. This is how you need to find the value of x. And these two questions are very important for the examination point of view. Now let me go to the seventh main. So seventh main heading, children, factorize the following expressions. We need to factorize. Factorize means bringing the expression into the form of factors, right? So first question, z square minus 4z minus 77. Factorization can be done in the methods, children. One is by taking common in between the terms. If it is not possible, then start using of identities. If no identity is, then you need to go with splitting middle term. That is nothing but the last identity which we have used. X plus a into x plus b is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus ab. That identity you can go. Okay. Then how to do this? First multiply the coefficient of z square with the constant. That is 1 into minus 77 is nothing but minus 77. Clear? Then here we have minus sign. When we'll get minus? Plus into minus is nothing but minus. Clear? Then go within a table to get 77. Here, since you have unlike signs here, if you subtract, you should get 4 as the answer. So if I go with 11 table, 11 sevens are 77. Yes, I got 77, which I required here. Next, 11 minus 7 is equal to 4. Yes, which I required. But you remember here you have minus 4, means the bigger number should be negative and the smaller number should be positive to get minus 4. Yes? Yes. This minus 4z will be written as minus 11z plus 7z and the last term as it is. So the 3 term of an expression is made into 4 terms, right? Now you go with the common. What is common between first and second? Z is common, right? Then 1z minus, already the z is taken outside, only the coefficient will remain inside. The same thing you write it without looking anything, children. Now you go with the third term plus, so plus, already z is taken within a bracket, so left out is 7. Now you can check it. 7 into z is 7z, minus into plus is minus, then 7 11z 77. Next, what is common in between these two? Z minus 11 is common, right? Then remaining whatever it is there, you put it in within the another bracket. So these are the two factors for the given expression. Now we'll go with the second. The second question is x square plus 25x plus 144. Multiply the coefficient with the constant. We'll get 144 plus 144. Plus will come when we multiply minus into minus or plus into plus. It depends upon the sign, whatever it is, plus. So we should go for this. Don't go for minus sign. Clear? Then choose the table where you will get 144. So here, if you didn't get any idea, children, let me give the clue. Go for prime factorization. 2 7s are 14, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 2 6s are 12, 2 1s are 2 8s are 16, 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, then 18 plus 8 is 26, no, 2 9s are 18, then 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 16 plus 9 is 25, yes, 16, 9s are 25, sorry, 16, 9s are 144, 16 plus 9 is 25, sorry children, then 16 plus 9 is equal to 25 and 16 9s are is 144. So x square plus 25x can be written as 16x plus 9x, and last term, that is 144 constant, keep it as it is. Anything common? Yes, x is common, then x plus 16. Here also you write it x plus 16 as it is by leaving little bit of space. Then third term plus sign, x is already taken within a bracket, left out is 9. Then in between these two, x plus 16 is common and the left out is x plus 9. So these are the two factors. Yes. Now third question, x square plus 5x plus 104. So here 1 into 104 is 104, children. Plus sign you should get, depending on the middle term, yes, plus only. So plus into plus is plus. In case here if you have minus, then you should go minus into minus. Clear? Then 104 you don't know, then go for prime factorization. 2 5s are 10, 2 2s are 4, 2 2s are 4, 2 6s are 12, 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6. Whatever you do it, if you add, you should get 5x. And if you multiply, you should get 104. Sorry children, here is minus sign. I copied question wrongly. It is minus. So minus means plus into minus, minus. If you subtract, you should get 5x because of unlike signs. 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8. Then 13 minus 8, 5. So 13 into 8 equal to 104. Then 13 minus 8 equal to 5. But see children, what 5 you have? Plus 5 means bigger number plus and smaller number minus. So 1x square, and this 5x will be written as 13x minus 8x. And the last term minus 104 as it is. In between these two, x is common. Left out is x plus 13. Same thing, whatever you write within a bracket, that you write it as it is. Now come with the third term, minus sign, minus, x is taken outside, left out is 8. Then what is common between these two? X plus 13 is common. Remaining you put it in the another bracket. So these are the two factors for this. So it is like A plus B into A minus B. Sorry, X plus A into X plus B. Clear? Now let me go with the fourth question. The fourth question is 49x square minus 64. Then 49 is a perfect square of, and keep remember children, here it is of only two terms. Two terms, is there any identity suitable for the two terms? Yes. Which identity is suitable for the two terms? Right? Expression consisting of two terms. So it's nothing but a square minus b square, nothing but a plus b into a minus b. So 49 can be written as 7 square, right? 7x whole square minus 64 is a perfect square of 8. 8 square. It is in the form of a square minus b square. Nothing but a plus b into a minus b. First, you have to check, children. Is it any common possible? Is any identity suitable? Clear? Like that, you have to do it. Then a value is 7x and the b value is 8. Then it becomes 7x whole square minus 8 square is nothing but 7x plus 8 into 7x minus 8. So these are the two factors. That's all. Expression brought into the form of factor is nothing but factorize, or we can call it as factorization. Clear? Now let me go solving in fifth question. So the fifth question is x square minus 1 minus 2y minus y square. So here, children, the expression consists of four terms, right? Four terms. But no identity can be used here. So some tricks need to be used here to bring up the solution. What is the trick? Here we have x square. Here we have minus 1. 1 is nothing but 1 square, we can write it. But the thing is, 2ab. 2ab means a value we have x. So with the 2, there should be a variable x. But here we don't have x. We have, instead of that, we have y. So is it possible with these three? Yes. It's very important question, children. And need to be solved very carefully. I'll take here 1 outside. Okay. I mean sign, minus sign, I'll take it outside. Left out is 1. Already the minus sign is taken outside. So here it will be plus 2y. And here minus is already taken outside. So again it remains plus y square. Then is 1 can be written as 1. Only minus is taken outside, children. Okay, 1 can be written as 1 square plus 2 into 1 into y, it can be written like this, plus y square as it is. Is it in the form of a square plus b square plus 2ab? Yes, we know that a square plus 2ab plus b square is nothing but a plus b whole square. Then x square minus a plus b whole square. In place of a, what we have? 1. Plus in place of b, what we have? Y. And it's square. But still remember, children, the solution is not ended, because the expression, we consider this as a and this as b. Then what it becomes? A square minus b square. We know that a square minus b square is nothing but, we know that a square minus b square is nothing but plus b into a minus b. This is the identity we know, right? In place of a, what we have? In place of a, we have x. Plus, in place of b, 1 plus y, right? Into a minus b. A is nothing but x minus b. But b consists of negative, means each term of b value should be in opposite. Plus 1 becomes minus 1 and plus y becomes minus y. Are they in the form of factors now? Factors is nothing but within a bracket. Yes? Yes, this is how the fifth question. It is very important question, children. Now we'll solve sixth question, children. Clear? So the sixth question is 4 into x minus y whole square minus 12 into x minus y plus 9. Generally, what the children will do in the examination is they'll use a minus b whole square, and this they'll multiply within a bracket, and they'll make the solution to be so complicated. Don't do it, children, like that. So here, a x minus y whole square in the first term, and x minus y, same thing present even in the second term. So what I'll do it is put x minus y is equal to a. Take the alphabet other than the variable what they have given. Here they have given x and y. So other than x and y, I have considered as a. You can go with any other alphabet leaving x and y. Okay. Then the expression becomes 4a square minus 12a plus 9. Is it not correct, children? See, in place of x minus y, I have taken it as a. Then any suitable identity can be used? Yes, let me check it. 4 can be written as 2a whole square, right? And plus 9 can be written as 3 square. Minus is present here, 2ab. 2, a is nothing but 2a, b is nothing but 3. First you multiply and check, is it the resulting is 12 or not? 3 2s are 6, 6 2s are 12, a, yes. So we know that a square minus 2ab plus b square is nothing but a minus b whole square. Then in place of a, same a only, right? In place of a, we have a. In place of b, we have 3. Now substitute. A is nothing but 2a. In place of a, we have 2a. And then 2a minus, in place of b, we have 3 whole square. So what are the factor we got? 2a minus 3 whole square. But the given answer is not in a, it is in x minus y, right? So open the bracket, 2, a value is nothing but x minus y minus 3 whole square. So a removed and the value of a is substituted. Now you multiply these two inside, then you'll get 2x minus 2y minus 3 whole square. But he asked to be kept in factorized, right? So same thing, you repeat two times, 2x minus 2y minus 3 into 2x minus 2y minus 3. So these are the factors for the given question. Is it not easy, children? Yes, it becomes easy only when you practice more number of times. So we'll go for 7th question now. So moving to 7th question, children, here x square plus y minus xy minus x. So the expression consists of 4 terms here. Any common can be taken? First and second? No. So shall I regroup it? Yes. X square minus xy plus y minus x. Now the question arises, madam, why did you take second with third term with the second term? I'll go with fourth term with the second. You go, children, no problem. There also you can do it, okay? Shall I do that? Okay. That also I'll do it, okay? So in between these two, x is common. What is left? One more x minus here. Why? Because x already taken outside. Here, plus sign. Nothing common, so 1 is a factor of every number. I'll take it 1 outside, y minus x. But remember, children, here you have x minus y. Here you have y minus x. So make it as x minus y only. How, madam? You can change the sign by taking minus sign outside, minus 1. So when we do a plus b, can be written as b plus a, but their sign is not changed, okay? But when you are making y minus x as x minus y, then minus will come outside. So minus into plus is minus, 1 into x is 1x, minus into minus is plus, then 1 into y is 1y. Now in between these two, x minus y common, left out is x minus 1. I'll do the another method also, x square plus y minus xy minus x. Now let me take this fourth term with the second place. So minus x plus y minus xy, right? So I'll take x common between these two, then left out is x minus 1 plus what is common between these two, y is common, then left out is 1 minus x. Here also you can observe x minus 1 as 1 minus x. So 1 minus x I'll make it as x minus 1 by taking minus sign outside. Here plus is there. So plus into minus, minus 1. then this will be as it is. Now between these two, x minus 1 is common, then x minus 1. Same factors you'll get, children. Doesn't change anything. Clear? So let me go with the 8th question now. So now moving to 8th question. 81 into x plus 1 whole square plus 90 into x plus 1 into y plus 2 plus 25 y plus 2. By looking into question, don't get scared, children. Okay, so x plus 1 is here, x plus 1 is here, y plus 2 is here, y plus 2 is here. Means we need to assume something. So let us put x plus 1 as A. Other than the given alphabet you have to take, children. Another same thing is y plus 2. Y plus 2 as B. Now what happens? 81 A square. Right, in place of x plus 1 I have written as A plus 90 x plus 1 nothing but A, y plus 2 nothing but B plus 25 y plus 2 is nothing but B. Is it not easy, children? Yes, I think this is whole square given in the question, then it becomes whole square. Clear? Now, 81 is a perfect square of 9 and 25 is a perfect square of 5. Then 9a whole square plus 5b whole square. It's like a square plus b square. Now it should be 2ab. 2a is nothing but 9a, b is nothing but 5b. Now check it, children. 5 2s are 10. 10 9s are 90. A into B is AB. If in case the identity is not used or cannot be used in the expression, then you go for splitting middle term. What identity? A plus B whole square, A minus B whole square, or A square, A plus B into A minus B. I mean A square minus B square, A plus B plus C whole square. If it is not, then you go for last identity, that is x plus a into x plus b. That we can find by splitting middle term. Okay, then we know that a square plus 2ab plus b square is nothing but a plus b whole square. Then 9a whole square plus 2 into 9a into 5b plus 5b whole square is equal to a. A is nothing but, for your assumption, a is nothing but 9a plus b. B is nothing but 5b whole square. But observe in the question, the expression is not in terms of a and b. It is in the form of, in the variables of x and y. So 9, open the bracket, a is nothing but x plus 1 plus 5, b is nothing but y plus 2 whole square. Now you make it 9 within the bracket, that is 9 into x is 9x plus 9 into 1 is 9 plus 5 into y is 5y plus 5 into 2 is 10 whole square. That is multiplication of monomial with the binomial. Now 9x and 5y cannot be done anything, so you keep it as it is. Now plus 9 plus 10 is nothing but plus 19 whole square. Same thing, you write it two times. So these are the factors for the given question. So looking it is easy, children, but you feel difficult only when you start applying it, solving without seeing. Then you feel difficult. So practice well, then each question will be easy only. So in this main, all questions are very important, children. So let me go with the 9th question. The 9th question is x square plus y square plus z square by 4 plus 2xy minus yz minus zx. So the expression consists of 6 terms. So expression consists of 6 terms means which identity can be used? Check 6 terms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's nothing but a plus b plus c whole square. We have to arrange the expression into the form of a plus b plus c whole square. Clear? Now, we know that a plus b plus c whole square is nothing but, we know that a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca is nothing but a plus b plus c whole square, right? So, arrange it in the form of squares now. X square, yes, y square, yes, plus z square, but you have 4 in the denominator. 4 is a perfect square of 2. So, z by 2 whole square plus this is a square, b square, c square. Now, it should be 2ab. So, 2, a value is x, b value is y. 2ab arranged. Now, you have to arrange 2bc. 2, b value is y, c value is z by 2. Now, you cancel it. Cancel if I do, then y into z is yz. Yes. Plus 2bc over now, 2ca, 2, c value is z by 2 and a value is x. So, these two get cancelled, z into x is zx. But very important notice, children, in identity we have all are in positive. But here the expression somewhere the terms consisting of negative also. So, be careful there in that which terms are negative, you compare those terms. Which variable alphabet is same, that variable term will be in negative. So, common here? Z is common, means the value of Z will be in negative. So, minus 2 by Z. C value will be minus 2 by Z. So, minus. So, minus. So, now we have arranged with this identity. So, we know that a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca is nothing but a plus b plus c whole square. So now a value is nothing but x plus b value is nothing but y. Don't write plus now. C value is in negative. So minus value of c is z by 2 whole square. Since they asked factors, so this should be repeated 2 times. Z by 2 into x plus y minus z by 2. So, these are the 2 factors. Here you can write it as x square plus y square plus of minus z by 2 whole square plus 2 into x into y plus 2 into y into minus z by 2 plus 2 into minus z by 2 into x. So, this is all about 7th main, children, and this is all about today's class, and remaining part of questions from the brain teasers we'll do it in the next class, children. Have a nice day. Maintain your classwork neatly and please practice this chapter for more number of times, because this chapter is very very useful in the higher classes, children. So, don't neglect this chapter. Practice well. Have a nice day. Thank you, children. Thank you.